In other news, a gunman shot a federal security worker to death at Los Angeles International Airport and wounded at least two other people. It was the first time an officer of the Transportation Security Administration, or TSA, has been killed on the job. The attack touched off chaos as rescue workers rushed to get the victims away, and travelers took refuge outside if they could. Airport Police Chief Patrick Gannon said there was no warning.
An individual came into Terminal 3 of this airport, pulled an assault rifle out of a bag, and began to open fire in the terminal. He proceeded up into the screening area, where TSA screeners are, and continued shooting, and went past the screeners back into the airport itself.
The gunman ultimately shot it out with police and was wounded before being captured. Law enforcement officials identified him as 23-year-old Paul Ciancia of the Los Angeles area. For a time, the incident caused the Federal Aviation Administration to ground all departures from LAX. Flights bound there from other cities were ordered not to take off. Iraqi Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki appealed today for U.S. help against violent attacks by al-Qaeda militants. He wound up a Washington visit this week by meeting with President Obama at the White House. Maliki is seeking military and intelligence assistance. We'll have more on this story right after the news summary. In Egypt, thousands turned out to protest after Friday prayers in a show of support for deposed President Mohamed Morsi. They filled the streets and denounced Morsi's upcoming trial, due to start Monday. There were even chants calling for the execution of the military chief who led the coup against Morsi.
This trial is void because the military coup is void and has no legitimacy. This should never, ever happen, not even over our dead bodies. We will never accept a traitor and his accomplices to rule Egypt.
This is not a trial. Until now, no lawyer has been able to meet him, and no volunteer has been able to take a copy of the papers of the case. This is not a trial. This is a farce.
The military-backed government has cracked down on Morsi's supporters since he was ousted in July. Secretary of State John Kerry acknowledged today that U.S. surveillance overseas has crossed the line at times. The admission followed disclosures that the National Security Agency monitored German Chancellor Angela Merkel's communications and tracked phone calls and emails across Europe. Kerry addressed the issue over a video link for a conference in London.
In some cases, I acknowledge to you, as has the president, some of these actions have reached too far, and we are going to make sure that that does not happen in the future.
Kerry said he and President Obama learned of some of the surveillance after the fact, but he also said some of the information gleaned has saved lives. One-third of all the Texas clinics that perform abortions are now barred from doing so. A federal appeals court last night allowed new state restrictions to take effect, pending further appeals. The rules say clinic doctors must have admitting privileges at nearby hospitals, but many do not. Texas is one of a number of states to approve broad new curbs on abortions in recent months. In economic news, U.S. factory output expanded in October at the best pace in 2.5 years. That word came today in a closely watched survey of purchasing managers. And major automakers reported solid gains in October as well. Chrysler, Ford, GM, and Nissan posted double-digit sales increases over the previous month. On Wall Street today, the Dow Jones Industrial Average gained almost 70 points to close at 15,615. The NASDAQ rose 2 points to close at 3,922. For the week, the Dow rose 0.3%. The NASDAQ dropped 0.5%.